turn the camera on. That must have been a problem. I'm sorry about that.
You've been giving me fits all day.
We got one pump that keeps a load of fuel ready here, and then the second one, when it wants to hit, the governor tells that to drop down and inject. That's a fuel injector.
Fuel injection.
1892 style.
Oh.
See, the fuel goes right in here.
Oh, it
goes down
in,
there. You might
goes
see
in the intake tube. What does this do?
Well, this is
that just a chamber down in there? Just a hollow chamber?
Yeah. Yeah.
So did he sell plans with this, obviously?
No, he only sold the engine.
He made 30 the first batch, and then he made 20
the engine himself.
Right, sold the engine.
Yeah. I guess he made 48 of these and two doubles. Pull rod instead of a push rod. How are you today?
Good.
19.4. Nice to see it's still running. That's great. And here you have a model of an Eclipse, so Fairbanks Eclipse. Was that one built here or by the guy in Australia?
Huh?
That model. Was that built here or in Australia?
I don't know. I got it at...
There's a guy in Australia named Red Gidengold. He probably built 20 or 30 of those. He got the castings from here.
That one, part of the castings on the inside of Florida, it was built in Pennsylvania.
It's Mark? Yeah, Norbert Keeley. Yeah. Well, he's the guy that had the castings made. But then there was a guy in Australia that used to, a fellow here used to send him castings, and he'd build the engines and ship them back.
That one was
a dealer
out there in the U.S.
Yeah. kind of limiting how much I put in it so that it didn't blow oil all over the container.
Oh, okay.
Wow, such an engine without a little oil. That was awfully considerate of him, wouldn't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, there's all kinds of interesting things here in the flea market, part of the Eliot, Maine engine and tractor show. What I found here, this is an oversized egg beater. You can see how big it is. Now this is something, let's just say, if your wife can handle a jackhammer, she can probably handle an egg beater this big. It's about 30 inches tall. So, anyway, there you have it. How are you doing?
Good,
Joe. Good. What am I looking at here?
Standard spring separator.
Okay.
Standard spring separator.
Nice little end.
Paul, I'm Gil Garceau. Nice to meet you.
Where are you from?
I'm from Connecticut. I live in Torrington. I lived in Easton for a long time.
I'm living in Mass, right? I live 2 hours north from here. Now.
Is that right?
Yeah.
We used to go up to Calais to visit Dave Townsend. Fuzzy?
I'm going to make some training here.
Okay, sure. I grew up in Norwell.
Yeah.
Moved to Denver in 81 for 5 years and then came back. And
I was born and basically in Connecticut.
Uh-huh. Anyway, here's one of those model engines from, I think, Enfield. It's a copy of the old.
I can't see it because of the sun.
Oh, I'm filming right now.
Okay. Okay, you're filming mine.
Yeah, I am. That's okay?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, okay. And then here's a really nice saw rig that he built.
The only thing is I didn't put much teeth on the blade because I didn't want to have to bring too much wood with me.
No, that's smart. That's a good thing, right?
Nice.
Yeah.
That's all I can deal with this day because I can barely walk. You know, I used to have big engines, but now.
Right. Smaller is better.
No, you can't move them. I can't do nothing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Here at the Eliot Maine Show, here's Mike O'Malley on his way home from a fresh pick. Got a nice trailer load. All kinds of neat stuff here.
I'm sure I got fed back before I came home, yeah. Not here on the trailer. I'm in Littleton. It's at Route 495 and Route 2.
Here's a 1/3 scale model of the Galloway, 5/4 star. This is a small engine, a full start, 1/4 horsepower, Stewart 800 gas engine. Thank you.
Thanks.
Fairbanks water pump.
Okay, so he's marked and gauged the pump. Now she's moving a lot of water here. Moving a lot, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Good light on.
Yeah. Bubble maker.
That's it. I wish I could find more like that.
A little antique aquarium pump.
Yeah.
Probably run it as a steam engine too. It's good for making bubbles.
It is. Sometimes the bubbles are blowing across the aisle, you know, so everybody sees them.
Oh yeah. Here's some erector set stuff. Pretty easy.
Like what I do in the winter before the engine goes.
Yeah. And here's the first time I've ever seen it do a double pass.